The trading app Robinhood is going public, and it filed its S-1 with the SEC. Here's what I learned from the disclosures. Robinhood has 18 million funded accounts and $81 billion of assets under its custody. It plans to trade under the ticker symbol HOOD, and it plans to reserve up to 35% of its Class A shares for its own customers. This is unique for an IPO. Companies usually allocate less than 10% of the IPO shares to individual investors, and those shares usually go to friends or family of the investment bankers who worked on the deal. But Robinhood's mission is to democratize finance for all and make investing more accessible to everyday investors, so it makes sense that they'd hold some shares back for their own customers. Regular investors usually miss out on the day one pop in a company's stock price because they didn't get in at the IPO price. Now, Robinhood has three classes of shares. Class A shares, which are entitled to one vote each. These are the shares that are being offered in the IPO. Class B shares, which are entitled to 10 votes each and are only held by the two founders of Robinhood and their related entities. And Class C shares, which have no voting rights but are convertible to Class A shares at a date and time picked by the board of directors. Now, Robinhood pioneered commission-free trading, so you might be wondering how the company makes money. Robinhood listed three sources of revenue in its prospectus: transaction-based revenues, interest revenues, and other revenues. 81% of its total revenue in the first quarter of 2021 came from transaction-based revenues. This is revenue earned from routing orders for stocks, for cryptocurrency, for options, to market makers. You see, when a user buys or sells a stock, Robinhood needs to route that order to a market maker to execute the trade. The market maker then pays Robinhood a portion of the bid-ask spread. So ultimately, the market maker is paying Robinhood to send trades their way. The market maker that Robinhood used the most was Citadel Securities, which accounted for about one-third of Robinhood's transaction-based revenues. When Robinhood receives fees for routing stock or option trades to market makers, these fees are called payment for order flow. When Robinhood receives fees for routing cryptocurrency trades to market makers, the fees are called transaction rebates. So payment for order flow and transaction rebates, those are the things that make up transaction-based revenues for Robinhood. Now, about 12% of Robinhood's total revenue during the first quarter of 2021 came from interest. Robinhood earns interest on margin loans, securities lending, and deposits. The remaining 7% of Robinhood's total revenues came primarily from Robinhood Gold. That's a paid subscription service that provides premium features to users. In total, Robinhood generated $137 of revenue per user during the first quarter of 2021. That's a 65% increase from the same quarter the year before. And Robinhood's top-line revenue quadrupled over the same time period. But is Robinhood profitable? Well, it posted a $7 million profit during 2020. But in the first quarter of 2021, Robinhood lost $1.4 billion. That's a huge loss, but it was due to a single line item, a fair value adjustment for convertible notes and warranty liabilities. Here's what happened. In February of 2021, we had the meme stock frenzy with GameStop. People were trading so much that Robinhood ran into a liquidity problem. Robinhood needed cash, so it issued two tranches of convertible notes to raise $3.5 billion. The holders of the notes got 6% interest. Plus, the notes convert to shares of Class A common stock when Robinhood goes public. The holders of one of the tranches also received warrants. The warrants allow them to purchase Class A shares equal to up to 15% of what they invested in the convertible notes. The convertible notes and the warrants were a liability that appeared on Robinhood's balance sheet. Robinhood estimated that the fair value of this liability had increased by $1.5 billion since the notes had been issued. Thus, Robinhood recognized a $1.5 billion expense for the increase in the liability. But if we ignore that fair value adjustment, Robinhood about broke even during the first quarter of 2021. But because Robinhood has had such strong top-line revenue growth, a lot of investors are really excited about the IPO. But Robinhood faces multiple risks, including regulation, increased competition, and conflicts of interest related to its business model. With respect to regulation, Robinhood has been criticized for allowing everyday investors to take risks that they don't fully understand. It recently paid $70 million to settle claims that it misled investors and restricted trading. With respect to increased competition, most of Robinhood's competitors began offering commission-free trading in 2019. Robinhood still has a unique trading platform, but it can't rely on attracting customers anymore just by offering commission-free trades. But the biggest challenge faced by Robinhood going forward might be the conflict of interest that's inherent in its business model. Robinhood says its goal is to serve investors, but the majority of its revenue comes from payment for order flow. What if Robinhood starts routing trades to the market makers who pay the most money, but this isn't necessarily in the best interest of its clients? Now, Robinhood benefited greatly from COVID-19, the stay-at-home orders, and the government stimulus payments that gave everyday investors more money to put in the market. But it'll be interesting to see if Robinhood's business model can achieve high profits in the long run.